Hi, Nanika here, and in this video, we are gonna continue building this survey. So, on the last video, we have created the calculate average formula. So, if you've missed that, check out the last video that's connected to this one. In this video, we are gonna create the CCT or the custom content types to store the answers of those users who's gonna take the survey in this CCT. Now, we're gonna use CCT because we don't really need all of those fancier stuff that the CPT can do. We just need to make sure we have a place where we store their answers and use that to maybe calculate later whatever we need. But in the last project that we built, we did use CCT for that. And so far, we created those reports without any problem. Plus, the data that the CCT hold or save is much cleaner, so it was much easier to create the result. Okay, so let's get started. So first is we're gonna create the CCT. So to do that, we need to go to Jet Engine, and then under Jet Engine, you can see that here we need to enable that first. So let's just search for the custom content types. By the way, I am zoom in 2 times, so I just want to make sure that it is like as clear as possible for you, but in your end it should look like this. Okay, so custom content types, so let's enable that and then save. So once that is enabled, you can see on the sidebar, we have this custom content types added. So let's go in this page and create our CCT. So we're gonna name our CCT survey logs. So survey logs. And then it should, like this log should automatically follow that format. But if you need a custom one, make sure to set that in here, because later on I don't think you can change that with the CCT. And then we don't need the other stuff here, but for the menu icon, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna look for, I think, doc, this one, and then menu position. So we're gonna leave that as a default so that it is included in this section. And then leaving that as default. And then at the bottom, we're gonna start creating our field. So by default, you're gonna have this already. So item ID, it's your choice if you want to enable some of the fields here, but for this use case, we're gonna need the item author enabled, the created date as well. And then so far, we don't need the other stuff here. So we're just gonna create and add the content type and continue to edit this. So now after creating the CCT, you can see on the sidebar, we now have a specific section for that. So if I zoom in, it says CCT survey logs. Okay, so we're gonna need some fields. So based on the question that we have set up, so we need a field to hold the category 1 average, the category 2 average, the category 3 average, and of course the overall average. So let's create those fields. So go back to your CCT custom content types and then click the new button, and then we're gonna add some fields here. So first is we're gonna add average 1. If you want, we can do a full word. So average 1. And then the slug should automatically follow. And then for this one, I need this to be, I'm just gonna leave that. I need this to be like number. And then I'm gonna add a new one. Average 2. Average 3, and then overall average. And then update. So now we have all of the fields that we need. If we check the survey logs, and we can try to add a new one manually, but as you can see, we have the average 1, 2, 3, and then overall average. Now you could add more fields here. So example, in the last project that's similar to this, we added more fields because the project required it to calculate more data based on which page the question was coming from. They also want to capture the survey name and other stuff. So it really depends. It's very flexible, but I'm gonna make it simple for this example so that you can follow. But it's not limited to these fields. You can even create select field checkboxes or so on. Okay, so now that the custom post type is ready, let's now proceed to creating the post submit action that needs to be set up in the form itself. So in the form, so we have already tested the form on the past video right here. So in the form, in order for this to work, we need to create some post submit action. So this is not like locked into just this post submit that I'm gonna create right now. You could even send email or do other stuff. But in this example, what we need to do is we want to store their answers on the CCT that we created after they submit the form. Now, to do that, we need to insert the CCT action in here. So I'm just going to remove this because I don't need that here. We're going to add a new action, and then we're going to select insert update post. And then select this pencil icon, and then it's gonna pop up this options for you. So first we need to call that post type that we have made. So, well, I think I need to change this. Hold on. It needs to be, I need to refresh. Hold on. So refresh the page because this one, I opened it before I created the CCT. So let's do that again. So add new, and then it should create a new insert update custom content type item. So the earlier one we created, we selected was the insert update post, which will work for CPT, but for this case, we need it to work with CCT. So we're changing that. So I'm gonna select that and click the edit pencil icon. So the indicator that I saw earlier was this said different. It should be content type. So now we are in the correct page. So if I'm gonna select that, I should see the survey logs. And then for the item status, I'm gonna leave that blank because I didn't really enable the status on that log CCT earlier. So I don't need that. What I need are the results. So to make this work, I need the, so example, category 1 average. I need to store that in the average 1 field that we created in here, right? And then we're going to proceed to the lower part, and we now see the average 2. And then, of course, average 3. And last but not the least is the overall average. So for this one, and then I'm then gonna update that, and that's what I need for that setup. Next is I'm just gonna try to create a redirect to a page. For this one, I'm gonna redirect it to the results page. So I created a results page earlier. So for this one to use, so it's name survey results, so we're just gonna use that page in here. So static page, and we're gonna find that survey results page and then click update. Okay, so now let's test this form. So example, if I'm gonna take the survey, and let's just say I'm gonna randomly answer this. Okay, so I'm just gonna create a note or try to remember. I have category 3 average as 3 and then overall average as 3.1. And then I'm gonna click submit and it should land me to the survey results page, which worked. On the survey log, if I go there, I should see that stored under my account. Now, I want to see those scores, so I'm just gonna go back to my custom content type and enable those columns. So I want average 1, 2, 3, and overall average to show. Okay, so I now see that in here. Okay, so I'm missing those decimal points that I actually want to record as well. So I think I'm gonna need to change the type of my CCT here. So rather than text, I'm gonna change it to rather than number, I'm going to change it to text. Okay, so I'm going to try that again. So this first test didn't have the decimal points. So we're gonna try to take the survey again. See if our decimal points are also recorded. Oops. Refresh. Okay, so we now have our decimal points. So we needed to change that field, but it's now working. So that's what we want for this video. We want to create the CCT and we want to create the post submit action. Now in the next video, we're going to try to create the JUT listing and design some stuff in the results page as well. So I hope this video helps and you have learned something from it. Now if you're still feeling stuck on how to create and manage your WordPress membership site, visit us at wpmembershipdesigns.com where you can learn how we can help with your projects and you may also book a call to determine if we are the right fit for your needs. Again, thanks for watching this video. If you have any question regarding this, please comment it down below and I'll do my best to answer your question as soon as I could or else create a separate video tutorial regarding that. That's it for this video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye!